In order for kinetic tracking to work, you must have purchased the Kinetic Tracking plugin from Pangolin and had your license file flagged. Before we can start to track kinetic balls, we must start first by setting up DMX input. This can be done with either DMX using something like an NTEC box or ArtNet. Go to Settings, DMX, DMX/ArtNet Settings, and enable a DMX universe input either using ArtNet universes or by selecting an NTEC box. Once you're receiving DMX, which can be seen using the DMX monitor, you're ready to start tracking. Kinetic tracking features are located in the standard Quick Targets Beam Settings window. Added, you will see the option to create a path beam type instead of just a static beam. This is what will allow us to create a path for the beam to follow along the path of a kinetic fixture. Start by selecting a beam to work with, enabling that beam, and setting a zone for that beam. We will then select Path. This will open many options below to create your path. On your DMX console, or whatever is controlling your kinetic fixture, you can bring your kinetic fixture to its start point, and then we can set the start point position where the laser beam hits the kinetic ball in real life. Then, we can use the console to bring the kinetic fixture to its endpoint, and position our beam to the endpoint. If your kinetic is inconsistent or have a complex setup, you can set more points in the middle or by 25% or higher to create a more accurate tracking. Now that we have assigned a start, end, and any middle points, we can get the beam to follow the DMX values and position itself automatically. Under Path Control, you can select if the fixture is 8-bit, 1-channel, or 16-bit, 2-channel. Select your DMX input, what you set up earlier, and the position starting address for the fixture. If you're not using the full length of your kinetic ball, and your endpoint is not the full DMX value set, then you can change this here. If this is set correctly, your beam will track position to the DMX value of the kinetic fixture in real life. Note, you must press OK on this window and have the DMX input button selected here. Now we can set our color control for our beam. Select Beam Sequence if you want to determine the color and brightness in your Quick Targets tab, Own Color if you want to set its color here, or DMX In to have the console control its color. This should be the RGB values of the kinetic fixture itself, or patch separately in the console to control the kinetic fixture's color and the beam color separately. Here we can enable RGB and enable a dimmer channel. In my console, I've added separate RGBI generic fixtures to control and color my beams. Enter those channels from your console here. Now, if you've done this correctly, what'll happen is the laser will follow the DMX channels exactly. However, because these fixtures are physical objects and have motion and physics, what's going to happen is the beam is going to go to the immediate position that the DMX has, but the ball is going to lag behind. So we've included a feature where you can actually accelerate the beam to act like a normal real life fixture. So underneath speed control, what we're going to do is we're going to enable this control of the speed. And then we can select our DMX input and our channel number if our fixture has a speed master channel on your fixture. I actually like to just put that at max at all times, so I'm going to set this to a value that is not used in the patch. Then what we'll do is we'll set an acceleration that's quite fast so that we don't have any problems with it, and I'm going to make a guess at how fast my balls will move. Speed here is all about how fast the top speed of your ball is. Acceleration is all about how long it takes for it to get to that top speed. These values right here will be the same if you are just using to not have control of the speed fader on your console. I actually recommend this, as most people are going to create their motions that are slower, and it'll work better anyway. So let's give this a shot. Once we've put this in, I'm going to press OK, and now you can see that the beam moves in a way that's kind of like a kinetic ball. We just have to match it. So at first, we're just going to look for the actual speed at the top speed, which looks a little too fast. So let's bring that down. Go back into here, and we'll change this to say maybe 25. And let's see what that looks like. And again, we're just interested in how fast the beam moves at its top speed. It appears to be a little too slow, so that the beam kind of lags behind the ball. So let's adjust it a little bit more. And I fine-tuned this earlier, so I can put in what I learned earlier, which was 26.9, and I'll put that in for both. So now, ignoring the acceleration, the beam will move the exact same speed as the ball at its max speed, So let's just adjust our acceleration. Let's go back into here. And let's change our acceleration value to, say, 25. Now you can see the beam kind of sits on the ball and follows, but it's a little bit off still. It looks like that the beam could accelerate a little bit faster. So let's go into our quick targets here again. And let's set this to 30. Now, when I move this, the beam should sit on the ball and follow physically just like the ball. In extra anchor points, you can adjust the anchor points. So if you experience tails on your beams, you can add or subtract anchor points to fix that here. In custom image, you can change your simple beam to any frame or animation, even create shapes and abstracts instead of just a simple point, creating cool looks, moving images, or potentially even fatter beams. Thank you for watching our quick hints video on our Kinetic Tracking plugin. If you still need support, you can contact our support line. Or, if you have time, you can watch our deep dive video on kinetic tracking. Thank you for watching.